Hi guys, and welcome to a new video. Today's video is going to be about minimalism. And if we do not know each other yet, my name is Dominika and I make videos about minimalism, low-waste lifestyle and veganism. If you were watching my videos, probably you might have seen that I've been posting two videos at the same time. The thing is that I am posting in English, but also in my mother language, which is Slovak. Yeah, so today's video is going to be about what I have learned on my journey with minimalism, what minimalism brought me, what does it teach me. But before dive into the video, I just want to make sure that what is actually minimalism? A lot of people think that minimalists are people who have only 5 pairs of jeans, 2 pairs of shoes, which is actually not true because we all are different. And for every one of us, minimalism means something different. Like for someone, it could be a real like white, clean apartment, but for someone else, it could be traveling around the world with just a single backpack. Like, we are all different. Minimalism for me, it has no definition and it also do not have any rules. On the other side, getting rid of stuff that I do not want anymore, I do not like anymore, and things that do not make me happy. Let's just get into the video. So the first thing is minimalism is gonna save you money. I know it might sound really obvious, but it is actually true. Because if you stop buying things that you don't need, things that are unnecessary for you, you obviously gonna save some money. Let's say you wanted to buy something, but you couldn't afford it at that time because you were buying another stuff that were cluttering up your home, you didn't need. Save some money for something that you've been dreaming of for ages. But not only things you could buy, you can also experience other things, like you can afford traveling, or you can educate yourself, you can go to school, you can do courses, you can do sports. It's not only about things, but also about experience. You actually gonna learn the value of the money. Another thing is you're gonna earn so much space, like also in your home, but in your mind too. You're gonna have to rid of things, but I'm not saying that you should throw everything straight to a trash bin. You can give it to someone, you can sell it to someone, you can donate it to someone. Maybe you can also make place for something that you always wanted to have a place for, but you didn't have any place for that because it was cluttered with stuff that you didn't even use. Try to keep your home simple. Make space for things you need and you want, and get rid of things that you do not want anymore. You're gonna find things quicker. And let me say, this is so true. I know that it might sound obvious, but in your cupboards, in your wardrobes, you're gonna find stuff so much more easier because everything has its place and you see, you have more overview about your things. You're gonna clean a lot less. You don't need to wash, you don't need to iron, you don't need to clean that often. When you have a lot less stuff, you're gonna have also a lot more time. Get you more time for another things that you maybe wanted to do, but you were busy with shopping, with buying stuff. You will get more time for you, but also for the others. Spend your time with the family. So having less things in your home is gonna make you more productive. You will be able to learn better. When I tried to learn in my room, I was always disturbed by everything. I felt like something's gonna fall on me and I saw things here and things there, and I wasn't really concentrated on my work. So basically, if you want to learn and if you want to be more productive, it doesn't have to be necessarily like learning, but also reading books or concentrating yourself on something that you want to do at that time, make sure that you have less things around you, that everything is organized, and believe me, you're gonna be much more productive with a lot less clutter, because there is no stuff disturbing your attention or taking your attention away. Another thing that I actually love about having less things is that I do produce less waste, and I also try to live more eco-friendly. When you stop buying things, you realize back then when you were buying stuff and clothes and things and this and that, you had so much trash in your everywhere, and also you were producing waste. Now when I want to buy something, I always think about the product and about the item, if I really need it, if I really want it, how often do I gonna use this thing. If you decide to buy something, you have to be aware of the fact that you're gonna support a company. Not every company is producing eco-friendly things. So when you purchase something, think of the item, if it were made, how was it made, what were the working conditions like. The good example is like fast fashion. Stop buying fast fashion. I will never ever support companies like that again. Think of it. And also on the other side, think of the waste that you will produce with your buys. So what I also learned is that I actually got more happier. When you get rid of things that you didn't even like, it's like, oh, you feel so free. When I started to get rid of things and selling my things that I didn't even liked anymore, I didn't want anymore, I was feeling a lot happier. Happier also with myself, happier with the space that I made in our home. And when you feel happy, you're also gonna love you more, and also person or people you live with. If you haven't used things for a couple of months, couple of years, you're not gonna use it ever again. So get rid of things, get rid of things, make place for you, feel free, be happy, like get rid of stuff that is annoying you and is getting on your nerves. And the last point is, I think this is like connected with all of the tips and points that I mentioned in today's video, and it's about you gonna realize what is important for you and in your life. So when you have things that makes you happy, you realize what is important for you and in your life. And it doesn't necessarily need to be like a thing. It could be a person, it could be experience. You're gonna think differently about the whole situation. Rethink your values, and because life is too short to be cluttered. I mean, get rid of things that you don't want, get rid of that stuff, declutter everything that you can, and rethink your values, find out for you what is important in your life, what you want to do, and do it. Yeah, so I think that was it for now. Oh my god, I hope this video is not too long, and I hope you enjoyed it. If you want to know more on this team, make sure that you read my blog or just write me a comment, ask anything you want. If you like the video, I will be very happy if you will give it a thumbs up. And also check me on Instagram. And if you don't want to miss any of my other videos, make sure you subscribe and hit the red button. So I hope I will see you soon, and have an awesome day. Bye.